Una compatriota cubana me preguntaba en el avión que si era la primera vez que yo venía a Cuba. Le dije que sí, pero al mismo tiempo le dije algo que quiero repetir en este momento tan emotivo, tan emocionante. Primera vez que vengo físicamente, porque en sueños a Cuba vinimos muchas veces los jóvenes latinoamericanos. En sueños a Cuba, aquel Simón Rodríguez que dejó para todos los tiempos de América Latina como un reto para nosotros, aquello de que la América Latina, en ese tiempo América Meridional en el término, no podía seguir imitando servilmente, sino que tenía que ser original, y llamaba a inventar o errar. Sandino Mariátegui, ahí están las raíces de un proyecto de nación, una sola nación que somos todos los latinoamericanos y caribeños. Un proyecto en el cual no es aventurado pensar desde el punto de vista político en una asociación de estados latinoamericanos. ¿Por qué no pensar en eso? ¿Por qué seguir fragmentados? El siglo que viene para nosotros es el siglo de la esperanza, es nuestro siglo, es el siglo de la resurrección del sueño bolivariano, del sueño de Martí, del sueño latinoamericano.
Hugo Rafael Chávez Frías, or Comandante Chávez, as he was affectionately known by his supporters and his followers, passed away on March 5 at 4:25 p.m. local time, following a 21-month battle against cancer. When he died, at 58 years of age, he had become one of Venezuela's and perhaps even the world's most important contemporary leaders, having launched what he and his movement called the Bolivarian Revolution, named after Simón Bolívar, the 19th century independence hero who had liberated Venezuela and four other countries from Spanish colonial rule. Chávez was a devotee of Simón Bolívar,
and his vice president, Nicolás Maduro, recently referred to Chávez as the new liberator of the 21st century. Whether this is a fair assessment, only history will tell. But what is certain is that Chávez changed the face of Venezuela during his 14 years as president. Regardless of whether Chávez was the new liberator of Venezuela, he did leave a tremendous legacy, and with many achievements, but also with some unachieved projects. Among the unachieved projects are getting rid of inefficiency and corruption in the public administration, and lowering the country's high crime rate. The persistence of these problems probably help explain why Chávez got re-elected in October of 2012 by a margin of only 55% to 45%, a smaller margin than his resounding 2006 victory when he won with 63% of the vote. That he was able to win re-election after 14 years in office and despite massive opposition from the country's old elite is no small achievement, however. This achievement was possible because Chávez accomplished more than most people realize. In the area of foreign policy, Chávez was perhaps the most important driving force for regional integration. He greatly expanded an oil program for the Caribbean known as Petrocaribe, where island nations receive oil and oil infrastructure at highly preferential financing rates. He then launched, together with Cuba, Bolivia, and later Ecuador and Nicaragua, among others, the Bolivarian Alliance for the People of Our Americas, known as ALBA, which is a counter-model to the predominant free trade agreements of the region and would promote trade on the basis of solidarity and cooperation instead of competition. He was also one of the main forces behind the establishment of the Union of South American Nations, UNASUR, to which all South American countries belonged. And, most recently, he helped launch the Community of Caribbean and Latin American States, CELAC, which is a regional body that includes all countries of the Western Hemisphere, except the United States and Canada. One of the consequences of this integration process has been to end the isolation of Cuba. Finally, he was also one of the world's most vocal opponents of U.S. foreign policy, vociferously rejecting U.S. wars in Afghanistan, Iraq, and Libya, and opposing Israel's attack on Gaza. For that, he became one of the Arab world's greatest heroes. Another important accomplishment that is often overlooked is that Chávez served as an inspiration for voters and politicians throughout Latin America, who began voting for leftist parties and leaders throughout the continent. He inspired people because he was one of the few politicians who said what he thought and who acted on what he said without hesitation. In this sense, he began a project of reinvigorating socialism in 2005 when he declared himself to be socialist, and when he subsequently launched a new political party, the United Socialist Party of Venezuela, PSUV. The reinvigoration of the socialist project was important because he made clear that he espoused a 21st century socialism, by which he meant a socialism that would be participatory and fully democratic in contrast to the 20th century state socialism of the Soviet Union. But what exactly did this Venezuelan path to socialism consist of? For one thing, Chavez placed an important emphasis on creating a more equal country. As soon as he came into office, he strengthened discipline within OPEC, which raised oil prices within a year of his being elected. Next, he increased oil production royalties on the country's public and private oil industry and nationalized large parts of the private oil industry. With a tremendous boost in oil revenues, he was able to launch numerous new social programs, one after the other, having to do with the eradication of illiteracy, providing elementary, high school, and university education for the country's poor, giving financial support to poor single mothers, expanding and increasing retirement benefits, providing neighborhood doctors to all communities, introducing comprehensive land reform program, and, most recently, launching a massive public housing construction program, among many other social programs. As a result of these policies, inequality decreased so much that Venezuela went from being the country with one of Latin America's greatest income inequality to the one with the least income inequality. Also, he managed to reduce poverty by half and extreme poverty by two-thirds. Another important accomplishment was the introduction of participatory democracy in Venezuela. This project, which is still incomplete, has put over 30,000 communal councils in charge of their own neighborhoods so that people feel like they have a stake in their future like never before. This feeling is borne out in opinion polls about what Venezuelans think of their democracy, where Venezuelans rate their democracy more favorably than citizens of almost any other country in Latin America. Also, a larger proportion of Venezuelans vote and participate in political activities than anywhere else or at any other time in Venezuelan history.